Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrated. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 222. Meta has announced its first consumer AR glasses, Project Nazar. The glasses offer familiar AR experiences such as communicating with friends in virtual windows and playing multiplayer skins using avatar. Meta CEO Mark Zuckerberg clarified the AR glasses are still a work in progress. Facebook officially announces renaming itself to Meta. This branding strategy comes as CEO Mark Zuckerberg looks to realign the company as a metaverse company. This transition has been scheduled to stretch out over several years. Whoever wants to grab the Geophone Next, you will be able to purchase a Geophone Next by paying just ₹1,999. Though the upfront price of the phone is ₹6,499, that means those who want to buy the phone but cannot spend a big chunk of money at once have an option to pay a nominal amount and get the phone, and then they can pay the rest ₹4,500 in the form of EMIs. The first plan is called as Always On Plan. Users opting for this plan will have to pay ₹350 for 18 months. Or ₹300 for 24 months. This means that they can get 5 GB of data per month along with the 100 minutes of free calling. Customers going for the large plan can choose to pay either ₹500 for 18 months or ₹450 for 24 months, and return they will get a 1.5 GB per data alongside the unlimited calling. Reliance Jio will be launching a Jio phone next on Diwali 2021. Ahead of the launch, the device's retail box has been leaked online by a Twitter user confirming the key specifications. At the front of the box is an image of the device, below which is created with Google branding. The rear side of the box reveals the specifications and key features of the Jio smartphone. This phone will be having a 5.45 inch display with a HD plus resolution. As revealed in the image, this phone has thick bezels above and below the display. Reliance has packed a 3500 mAh battery in the Jio Phone Next, which can be charged via micro USB cables. This phone comes with a 2 GB of RAM and a 32 GB of internal storage. Users can expand the storage by up to 512 GB via micro SD card slot. In terms of performance, the phone comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 215 processor. It has a single 13-megapixel primary camera at the back and an 8-megapixel front camera. The dual SIM phone comes with a 3.5mm headphone jack and runs on Android-based Pragati OS. It will come with all Jio and Google apps pre-installed. This includes Jio Saavn, My Jio, Jio TV, Jio Cinema, Google Play Store, YouTube, etc. IQ8 is reportedly gearing up for the launch of IQ8 Legend in India. There are chances that the Chinese IQ8 might launch as IQ8 Legend in the country. This device has today been spotted on the TÜV Rheinland certification website. The upcoming IQ9 could launch next year after the IQ8 series is launched this year in India. IQ9 is listed in the Indian IMEI database with the model number B2171A. The IQ8 series is expected to launch next month in India. Yesterday, Redmi unveiled its Redmi Note 11 series of smartphone in China. As far as the Indian launch of Redmi Note 11 lineup is concerned, we have some interesting details. Redmi Note 11 Pro and Note 11 Pro Plus Indian variant have been spotted on the Indian BIS certification website and IMEI database listing, hinting an imminent launch. Xiaomi is going to launch a new tab in the Bangladesh market, which is on 1st November 2021 at 11 a.m. Xiaomi CV, which is codenamed as Mona, visits Google Play console and Google supported device list. Poco has registered the trademark for the same in India. The electric vehicles include cars, scooters, camera drones and other stuff from the Poco. Realme has filed trademarks for electric vehicles, driverless cars, camera drones, children toys and others. The trademark application has been filed in India. Realme electric car to take up on Xiaomi's that is set to debut on 2024. The Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition have been delayed and will launch in early January 2022. To be exact, it will be on January 11, 2022. According to the other sources, Samsung currently has plans to open pre-orders for the S22 lineup in week 6 of 2022. To be exact, the pre-orders to happen in the second week of February, that is commencing on 2/7/2022. TCL Huaxin today announced the development of 75-inch 8K 265Hz 1G 1D display technology for TV. The company had last year premiered the first generation of 8K 1G 1D technology, but the new 2021 tech is a new milestone in terms of image quality, refresh rate and manufacturing process. Apple MacBook Pro 14-inch and 16-inch AirPods 3 go on sale in India. These products were initially expected to be available from October 26. The new MacBook Pro and AirPods 3 were announced at the Unleashed event on October 18. Apple CEO Tim Cook touched upon Apple's success in India during the company's quarter four earnings call. He also stated that company earned nearly one-third of its revenue from emerging markets. Apple also said that it generated quarterly revenue of $83.4 billion in the fourth quarter. Airtel CEO Gopal Vittal urged customers to remain vigilant about the calls made by cyber fraudsters posing as Airtel executives. He has also elaborated upon the common instances of fraud like fake UPI handles or websites. The customers can get calls or messages from the fraudsters claiming to be from a bank or a financial institution. Maruti Suzuki has said that it will not launch an electric car in the Indian market before 2025. With the fuel prices going up, the car market leader will intensify its focus on CNG offering of all its models. The company had earlier tested electric vehicle based upon its Wagner R but scrapped all plans citing lack of infrastructure. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.